This week I'm going to do another pistol review as we take a look at Walther Arms P22Q Target. This is another nifty piece by Walther, this time with a design similar to their famous P99. Once again, we have a fairly basic plastic case with foam interior. The P22Q Target also includes a detailed manual, spare magazine, some tools, and of course the pistol. One thing I really like about this case is the fact that it's got a fitted foam liner rather than the usual generic foam egg carton style we're seeing more and more these days. Walther's also thinking ahead by including a pre-scored section just below where the Picatinny rail would rest so you can store the pistol with a laser or light attachment. Unfortunately for Canadian buyers, the case doesn't include a lock ring, which is a shame since it would have made a really nice travel case if it did. Like pretty much everything Walther makes, the P22Q Target is a thing of beauty. Designed from the ground up specifically for the 22 long rifle cartridge, this is a gorgeous compact pistol measuring in at 7.8 inches long. The extended barrel and faux compensator help add enough length to not only improve the accuracy, but also ensure it complies with Canadian barrel length regulations in a way that only enhances the sleek styling of the gun. Beneath that same barrel, you'll also find a Picatinny rail allowing for the attachment of a laser sight or flashlight. Owing to its innovative polymer frame and zinc alloy slide, the P22Q Target is extremely lightweight at just 20 ounces. That makes it ideal for smaller statured shooters interested in something quick and easy to use. I'm not a big guy, so for me, this is a great little pistol that I can fire for hours on end. Another feature I love about this gun is that it's got fully ambidextrous controls. Both the thumb safety and the magazine release are fully functional from both sides. That's a very attractive design in a 22 since it makes it a far more versatile learning and training gun. Lefty, righty, anybody who wants to can operate this pistol in a way that feels completely natural to them, which lets southpaws focus more on their marksmanship and less on trying to remember which digit works which feature. In addition to the thumb safety, this pistol also features a magazine disconnect. As you can see here, when I remove the magazine and attempt to fire the pistol, the trigger mechanism fails to engage. I know not everybody's a big fan of that, but I tend to actually kind of like it in a non-combat pistol. The removable sights are a standard set of 3 dots. They're quick to acquire and work well in low and dim lighting. The rear sight's also completely windage adjustable. Another neat little twist that Walther's employed is the grip pattern. While most pistols are restricted to either a classic checking or a more modern raised horizontal line pattern, the style employed here is almost reminiscent of diamond plate. This helps make it resistant to sweat and grime, as well as easier to clean. The magazine's a standard Walther 10-shot Canadian legal model made from folded metal with a plastic follower. Although quite similar to the one that Walther makes for their licensed Colt 1911-22 replicas, I actually far prefer this one as it has a much nicer thumb saver. As you can see here, it's both wider and more contoured, making it much more comfortable to use. Just like those from the Colt, the P22Q Target's magazine ejects easily and loads smooth as butter. Best of all, the pistol comes with 2 magazines, so you're not stuck trying to track down a spare. It probably comes as no surprise that the fit and finish of this gun are superb. Walther makes some of the nicest 22 pistols I've ever encountered, and this one is no exception. The slide rocks smoothly and evenly, the hammer is firm, and the trigger breaks like a glass rod in exactly the same position every time. Likewise, the matte black finish is absolutely flawless. Every face and contour are perfect, with no marring or thin spots of any kind. I don't really have many complaints about the P22Q Target, however, if you're a very large shooter or you've got big hands, my guess is you may find this gun a bit on the small side, although still manageable. Wrapping it with a couple quick layers of grip tape or installing a larger backstrap are obviously going to help somewhat, but at the end of the day, this is still a compact pistol. Likewise, if you already own a P99 and you're itching for something similar in 22, I just want you to be aware that the P22Q Target, while similar to the P99, is still quite a bit smaller. It's also worth noting again if you're a Canadian consumer that the included form-fit case, although lovely, is unfortunately not legal for transportation or storage, meaning you're still going to have to buy something else to take it to the range. Aside from those very minor gripes, I actually really like the P22Q Target. It's clearly been made to some very exacting standards, with a lot of forethought put into comfort and functionality. A very affordable gun, it makes an excellent choice as a first pistol, particularly for younger or female shooters and lefties, finding much of what's available uncomfortably large or awkward to use.